Hi friends, my name is Borro Dante. Less overpaying. Today's patient is Quentin Lichette, and his little unfinished composition, which is basically just a piece of body at a certain angle, might be a breakdancer, might be a ghost. But I actually have quite an interesting story for this. I hope we'll be able to fit it into one episode. Well, I mean, we have to. This is the law of the jungle. So, let's do some overdrawing first. First of all, I'm just gonna say something about the way this is drawn. Like, if this was a sketch, then the line shouldn't be so clean. It's counterproductive. Well, I mentioned it quite a few times. And it's okay to send this kind of stuff for the overpaint, but it's just that you should be a lot more messy when you're building up the sketch part. So, what I was thinking of is that this is a giant, probably a cyclop, who's crawling out of the hole where he was sleeping, and there's like rocks, and this is like partially a cave. Maybe there's some kind of view in there. And behind these rocks, there are a couple of small adventure people hiding from him. I think I saw something like that in a movie when I was a kid. I don't know what it was. And the cyclop definitely wasn't crawling like that. Anyway, we'll see where it goes, but I want this to be a cyclop that's looking for humans in his cave. Now let's actually do it properly. But how though? I guess we should put the giant a little bit higher, like this. You know, the rule of thirds. Where is the rule of thirds? Kind of like that. But it's not like the head is the main part. Or is it? No, I don't know. It feels like this is the main part, so it's not super necessary to follow the rule of thirds, but I kind of like it lately. I don't know. So let's do some rough building up first. But the cave, of course, is not going to be so straight. Also, the cyclop is not gonna be naked, I think. That would be a bad idea. Oh, right. He's a giant. We shouldn't put the camera so high. It should be kind of looking from the bottom, right? Are we able to do that in the geometry of the character? Not really, because of this arm, this hand. We're looking at its plane from the top. I mean, we can change that, and I guess we will. And the way he's twisted, it can be whatever, so it doesn't really define anything. We see his chest sort of from the bottom, so it's cool. Let's kind of quickly, roughly change the hand. I'm not going to even pretend that I can do it easily in line art. It's just flat, it's not cool even. Okay. Also, the hands are kind of short. Yeah, let's do it a bit longer. I don't know, maybe it was supposed to be in some sort of foreshortening, but due to such a perfect clean line art, we can't see that. There's no, like, this going on to give us a hint that it's going away or forward. And I think we need it kind of straight, so that's where the giant is maintaining his balance. It just looks like a foot. Ugh, it's always hard when it's touching the surface. That's a good study to do, when the hand is touching the surface. Right, longer though. Like, I don't want to do the whole muscle building up here. Everybody knows it's easier for me to do in color. But what if? There's some pelvis missing, I think, and some rib cage. But that's just what I can pretend to see. Ah, a lot messier, a lot more pleasant to work on this when it's messy. And I believe we're not gonna see the chopped off legs anyway, and probably we'll cover some penis, although again, he's gonna wear some stuff. Okay, the geometry is basically the same as it was. Okay, let's see. So the horizon is probably right there. I'm not using Nozomi because I just don't want to use anything really. So there's gonna be like this going on, and then there's the view, like there. And we should also put more holes to kind of imply that there is a lot of them. Okay, this looks empty and unpleasant in here, so we should put something big covering up from the front plane, and everybody's gonna be a lot happier. Maybe like a giant bone somewhere. It's kind of bigger than the giant, which is not right. Actually, there should be kind of like human bones, right? That would make more sense. I guess this hand is going to be inside, otherwise it's a really awkward hand. So, and there's gonna be a couple of humans. The cave details should be kind of small to show that the giant is giant, but I mean, will it help? And I guess a bunch of bones and skulls in here. Now, let's put the humans a little bit to the right, because right now the whole composition is kind of like here, and what do we have all this for? And this is probably going to be like super dark, basically black, since we're in a cave, I guess. This is like the way out. Also, there should be probably like a torch, the cyclops-sized torch somewhere. Just for more of an interesting lighting. Let's think. From here, there will be a lot of daylight, right? In this whole area. So in here, it's gonna be darker. Okay, this small one, maybe it shouldn't be like an actual hole. Or let's keep it a hole, but in here there will be like a bonfire. So it sort of keeps them warm as well. This is the only way these monsters can sleep at night. Okay, maybe a couple of clouds, but just complimentary. Mostly sunny. Now, let's do a quick and robust and thoughtful and colorful rendering, keeping in mind all the lighting, but avoiding any detail. With a big brush, I guess this one. Okay, good enough. So the sketch is gonna be in multiply, and I guess let's just go in one layer, like a man. So the things I know, the closest thing is gonna be super dark. So let's do that. Okay, I think we might want to crop the right side of the image a bit, keeping this thing, but we'll see. Let's do the sky. Let's not push into very much of a colorful things. Oh no, we're in a black and white mode for some reason. That happens when you create a document based on JPEG file. RGB. Don't flatten anything. So this thing is also completely gray, right? That's uncool. Actually, it's a good reason to restart, because I guess it's a good idea to keep the front silhouettes in a separate layer. So inside of the cave, the color is going to be in between the skylight and the bonfire light. Well, sort of. I'm trying to think of the overall basic ambience in there to put the basic main color right now. So this is fire and this is sky. In between there's something greenish, but it's gonna be really pale because the colors are very much opposite. And let's go brighter, of course. So this is the middle area, middle plane. We just need something to start with. Now let's do the sky there. It should be brighter, just to increase the effect of HDR here, because the sky is like really bright no matter what's going on inside of the cave. Cave is really dark. So the wall should be darker than the floor, because the floor is catching a lot more of the skylight. Usually people just learn from references, but I prefer to go with my flawless logic. This one is also getting kind of vertical and also facing away at all. So there's something dark around here. Okay, now let's go with a soft gradient, darker when we're getting more into the cave. So we'll mix in this color. Ignoring the holes for now, because they'll change everything anyway. Alright, these are the basic holes. Now let's do the fire hole and change all the colors. Okay, this looks kind of interesting. I want to make you darker. I guess there's another hole in here too. So I'm trying to make sense of these stones in here. And I guess these are like a couple of stalagmites that were broken by the hosts of this place when they were decorating. I guess these ones should also have this kind of shape. Only random small stones should be sort of round or whatever. Thinking through some projected shadows from this thing and from the fire. Shouldn't be that sharp though. It's not a light bulb. I don't know, maybe just a hint in here. Just for the sake of it. Now let's do the giant really. So he's gonna be wearing some kind of leather thing, of course. Calculating in progress. So we have the daylight from here, so basically this normal skin color, and the firelight from here. Maybe it shouldn't be that bright really, considering the angle and all, but I don't care, I want some fire on the giant. So calculating the differences of the values at different angles and distances to make sure that the lighting is more or less fair. So this is what we got. It looks like he's scratching his balls in there. I guess we'll put the arm in a different position a bit, like he's gonna be grabbing the edge. So the anatomy in the initial sketch is far from normal human, and I think we should push it more. It's gonna make the Cyclop look even more fantasy kind of thing. But we should kind of like make it look like we meant it, not like it's a mistake. So now basically I think I like the colors. Still don't like the composition, like not completely. So let's move some stuff around and crop the thing. There we go. One third. And another third, there's the guys. Should we put them higher? Or should they be kind of like hiding even from us a little? Alright, we merged all of this. And then there's just the sky. Let's add some clouds and stuff. Now, since most big details are in place, let's play a little bit more with thinking through the light to make sure we have the best of it. So the guy's going to have probably a pretty massive jaw and small forehead to make him look a bit more primal. So moving on to elaborating into some details, adding some complex structure to the wall of the cave. Some creepy skull-like features of the face, so he would look like death the way I look. Let's make his garment a little bit more messy, otherwise he looks like he's just wearing some night tank top. Now let's make his arms less human. I think they should be like thicker, and the fingers are thicker, but there should be 5 of them, I think. Not too much, this is not Popeye. Wow, this is so interesting to create this kind of hand. It looks very curious, you're kinda like, wow, even his hand is unusual, legit giant. Cause we barely can see his face, so the most profound feature are going to be the hands. Something thicker, cause this guy would break this kind of small jewelry. This is starting to look kind of interesting. I'm enjoying myself. So let's thicken this arm as well. Wow, I'm so into this. It's been a bit of a while since the last time we painted an actual story thing, and this is like my favorite thing in the world. After eating bananas with almonds, of course. Food comes first. First you survive, then you make art. Now let's do some face. I almost went with two eyes, but let's actually push the one eye idea. Let's make the eye black, just so it fits the necklaces. Okay, interesting. I wanna work on the face a bit more, but first, let's thicken the back a bit. Also, this hand is made of wood. So the nose should start probably lower than the only eye in the middle, right? I wonder how that will affect the face. The prettiness. I think the ear is in the wrong perspective. Like it's facing it like this, when it should be more like this, which is, I can't see, but the point is it should be pointing at the camera more. Let's try and make that happen. Okay, cool. Now let's fix this arm and then move on to the guys and then work a little bit on the background, but not too much. And that will be it. Okay, it looks kind of better. I gotta admit, this must be the hardest hand I have ever had to deal with. Even though it doesn't have to follow the strict rules of anatomy, still it has to follow strict rules of geometry, which is a problem at this angle and contact with the surface thing. Some dirt on the fingers, of course. He should be really dirty, but I don't think I'm gonna pay too much time to that. Okay, the giant is almost done. Let's add a little bit of highlights on the jewelry. Okay, now for the dudes. They're almost going to be just silhouettes, really. And we should make them pretty high contrast, so they would be noticeable. Some kind of bag with them. So let's throw our last resources on adding some decency to the cave, because certain areas are like super blurry. So as far as I remember, stalagmites and stalactites should have a bit more of a spiky shape, not so much of a perfect cone shape. So let's adjust the shape a bit. So there's like whole trees in the bonfire. So let's show that. And there's another giant laying in there. Let's just give it a tiny hint. And it's gonna be awesome right away. Oh my god, this is so creepy. A bald head laying in there. Cool. Maybe let's add another one in there then. So remember the bones and the skulls? Let's try and add that. So let's do a trick. The point is, right now, to paint skulls that are white, but in the proper lighting, I kind of have to pick up the color and then light it up like this, bring it closer to white. And then it will be appropriate color for that place for a white skull. But this is kind of long to do that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna fill a new layer with white and make it transparent. And then on top, we just grab the color and paint with it right away. And then I turn off this thing and there are white skulls. I guess there's an easier way to do this, but I kinda like this idea. Although I can't see shit. Let's add shadows. I'm getting tired, so I become more inventive. I mean, we're not gonna keep these shadows, of course.
Done.
Well, this is an amazing piece of fantasy we have here. I don't know, it looks so interesting to me, at least. You, Franz, tell me what you think. I don't know about the mistakes I made or whatever, but it just looks very interesting. Emerging. Of course, we would do it very differently as a paint-through kind of thing. But I think it's pretty awesome as it is right now. Thank you, Quentin, for your contribution. This was a pretty inspiring line art you got there. This thing took 3.5 hours, including all the nonsense I was talking about. This was really refreshing and awesome. So Franz, I ran out of your artwork to paint over. Share links in the comments section on YouTube. Maybe on Twitter, but I guess there's a shitty resolution in there, but I'm not sure. Anyway, the best way is to upload it somewhere and just put a link in the comment. This is new, because recently I thought to myself, it's kind of stupid to only take your artwork for overpaint from Patreon page. Like, I don't want to force anyone to give me money or anything, especially if you want to help me with overpaint. So yeah, upload your artwork wherever you want, preferably in the YouTube comments section, or to put it right, preferably on Patreon, since those were the rules initially. I mean, if someone will be uploading on Patreon, they will be in a higher priority or something. I guess that's only fair. But yeah, upload your stuff, put it in the comments section, vote for the ones you want me to overpaint first, and we'll make it happen. Hopefully there will be a lot of artwork, because, I don't know, I think this is personally my favorite series on this channel, because it kind of involves you guys a lot, and also it's just an interesting experiment. So I hope I'll be able to actually start making these more frequently, although this spring doesn't really allow me to concentrate much on work. But yeah, I guess I said everything that was necessary to say, and I will stop now. And also, I'll thank you for watching if you did. I guess you did if you're here. Leave a like and subscribe. Tell a friend. Have a nap in a cave. Do whatever you want. And I will see you in the next one. Bye! Oh no, someone made a noise in my cave. I guess I'll look outside, that's probably where it came from.